Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another MicroTech tutorial. On this one, I'm going to be continuing my bucket series. I'm going to be covering permissions, which is important if you want to get your server up and running. This is one of the most important plugins you could probably have for your server other than essentials. That one also is very important. The two main, well, okay, there's three plugins that you can't literally, okay, there's like top five plugins that you can't really have a server without. Let's get started. So I mentioned in my last video that I'm not going to be using Chat Manager, and I will show you in this video why. So, if you go to dev.bucket.org/server-mod/permissionsx, don't worry, the link will be in the description. You'll see a couple download links. I'm just going to click on this one right there, and then I'm going to go ahead and hit download, and give it a second or two to download, and then double click on it. I don't want Modify World or Chat Manager. I prefer to use Essentials Chat, which, if you saw my previous tutorials on Essentials, it doesn't matter what chat manager you use. You just need to have a compatible chat manager with PermissionsX. So any major chat manager should work. I like Essentials Chat better. So I'm not even going to use that one. So I just extracted that. And let me open up my Minecraft folder real quick. And double click on it. And then go in Plugins. And then let's drag, not chat manager, sorry, PermissionsX in. And then let's close that, and let's go ahead and start our server. Now once it's started, it should take a second to load, and I'm going to actually go ahead and use Notepad++ to go ahead and make this permissions file. Now what's interesting about this is there's things called nodes, and that's how you basically code permissions. So you have groups, and then you have to give each group certain nodes. So let me just cover that real quick. Alright, I'm not going to show you permission nodes quite yet. I just wanted to go ahead and get that open real quick. So you want to go ahead and, like I said, go in your plugins folder and then find. Okay, so once you're in there, go to permissionsx and then open the permissions file, because you're going to want to type some things up. I like to use Notepad++, but you can use whatever you want. So the first thing you want to do is type groups. And what's important about this is we're using YML, so you need to have proper spacing in order for this to work. Otherwise, your server may get an internal server error and not even start up. So once we have groups typed, I'm going to go ahead and create our first group, which I'm just going to call guest for now. And then see how it automatically indents it? I'm going to indent again, and I'm going to give it some permissions. So I have a group called guest, and I'm going to make this the default group. So when someone joins, they'll automatically be the next player. Do you know how it's automatically indenting? And you see these little tabs here? This is all in guest, and guest is all in groups. So that's how you can see that you're doing it right. And you'll get a little red bar if you're doing something wrong. But it's not, it's pretty obvious to the program, but it's hard to demonstrate what you could do that's wrong. All right, so we have it as a default group. We already have it as the default, so I'm going to go ahead and give it a prefix, which just makes it a little bit easier. So note my indentation. So I'm going to put, and I'm just going to put it at E for whatever. I don't even know what color E is off the top of my head. And bracket, guest. And then end that. And then I want to give it some permissions, so I'm going to type permissions. And then I'm going to give it some permissions. So now I put a dash. Now, what are permissions? Permissions are easily known as nodes. And basically what they do is it gives you permission to do certain things on the server, mainly commands. And you're going to want to go to the plugin page and find the permissions. In this case, I'm just going to do some permissions for Essentials. And for most cases, at least with this plugin, Essentials, the command is part of the node, and this isn't always the case, so you need to Google it, because permissions are vary from plugin to plugin. So I know that I want to give the guests the ability to type /help, and I want them to be able to read the rules. And what else? I don't want to give them messaging yet until they're members, they don't get a home yet either. Okay, and let's see here. Then I want to go ahead and do options. And this is where you make it so when you promote people. So after members, you want to promote someone to member. So I'm going to call this rank. And then I'm going to put 1,000. 1000 being the lowest rank, 0 being the highest rank. I don't know why they do it in descending order. Do not ask me. I did not write the plugin. All right, and then I'm just going to go ahead and backspace a few times, and I'm going to create a new one called member, and I'm basically going to be basically doing the exact same thing, except this time you want to put false, and I'm going to change the prefix to a light blue, so member, and make sure you do this correctly in terms of spacing, which is why I recommend Notepad++. Permissions, I'm going to allow them to have warps, so warp, I'm going to let them have the home command, and I don't know, I'm going to let them set their home, because you kind of need to do that. Oh, and sets, and I'm going to also give them the access to spawn. Oh, and essentials TPA, essentials TPA accept, and then essentials TPA TP deny. Alright, so let's save that. But before we do, we also have to give it the rank. So options, rank, and let's give this 900. And save. Now let's go ahead and boot up the server. So it's already booted up, so I'm just going to hit type /rl, and I'm going to go ahead and open up Minecraft real quick, and I'm going to log in to the server. I see the Mojang, and then it says, give it a second to load. And if this is done correctly, I should test. It made me yellow. Now, if you want to change it, their name, and just do something like that, you can just do ANSI. I like to do ANSI for mods and NW for white non-mods, because non-mods typically with no permissions are white, and then mods typically are red, so that's why I do. And so if I go ahead and type reload, it should go ahead and reload. Now, what's interesting about this is you can actually, if I type something like hi, it says I am a guest. So if I type help, it only shows the commands that I have access to. So I currently have help and rules. So let me promote myself. So do pex promote, and then you can do this in game. I'm just doing it through the console because it's easier. Pex promote tech tube, and it should promote me to member. Now if I type hello, it made me green and it says I'm a member. Now if I type help, it says I do not have access to that command. Why? Because you have to set up something called inheritance. And no, I do not want to reload because the spacing by default annoys the crap out of me and I always mess up on it. Alright, so you actually have to set up inheritance. So if I go and backtrack here, you will want to type in inheritance, and then where you want to inherit from. So I want to inherit from guest, and I'm going to hit save. I'm going to reload, give it a second, and it made me a default again because I am still editing the live file and I didn't record it. So I'm going to go ahead and type pex promote techtube, and you can keep on promoting them that way if you want until they have the highest rank. So pec, and so if I do help now, you see I also get the top, so help rules, and then home, set home, TPA, TP deny, and all that. And you can go to multiple pages, so if I go to that page, it says help and then rules. So that's pretty helpful. I mean, it makes it easy to list all the different commands. So that's how you do that, and it inherits it. So now let's move on to users. So I already showed you pex promote, and to demote someone, you do pex demote. But I want to go ahead and make a group that gives someone every single permission there is. So I'm going to make it called admin. Now, what's cool about this is it gives them all permissions, but for the most part, at least I think so with permissions. Actually, you can't opt people unless you do it through the console. So if you want to give someone all permissions but don't want to opt them and just promote them to this rank, you can do so. And it also gives them a nice prefix. So I'm going to put default false. I'm going to give it a prefix of, excuse me, stupid keyboard messing up on me. And I'm going to do admin, close that, And let's make this a little bit bigger. And then ANSI, because like I said, I like to do that. And then let's give it some permissions. And let's, instead of doing listing all the commands, I can just do that. And notice you have to put single quotation marks around it. And then I can go ahead and do options, rank, and then 800, because that's the lowest rank there is. And then if I hit save, and then I go ahead and reload. This isn't not a short tutorial, because permissions is a pain in the butt sometimes. All right, so if I type test, it shows me as a guest. So if I type help, it doesn't show anything because it already showed the previous command. So if I do pex promote TechTube, I am now a member. So if I type hi and then type help, it lists all the commands. And then if I do pex promote again, it will promote me to admin. If I type something, it makes me an admin. And as you can see, I get all commands by default. Now that's very helpful. And you can actually promote people on game. So if I want to go make this a little bit bigger, let's do pex promote TechTube. Or no, I'm not going to promote myself. I'm just going to promote Notch, even though he already gets all commands. And notice how Notch has become a member. Let me make it bright. Okay, so Notch is now a member. And if I do that again, he is not promotable because I'm an admin and you cannot promote the same group as yourself. However, you can through console, which I showed you earlier. So let's say I want to go ahead and change my rank, just the prefix of it. I can go ahead and do pex, go slash pex, user TechTube prefix, and I'm going to make it MicroTechTutorials. I don't know. And white. I don't know. So now if I type something, it says MicroTechTutorials TechTube because that's my prefix and then it puts the username. So I can go ahead and do that. And if I want to remove it and just go back to the default one, I can just do single quotation marks, I believe. So let's try that out. So test. And for whatever reason, it doesn't want to make it get rid of my prefix, but you can delete it in the permissions file if you choose to do so. So I can do that. I can also add commands. So if I demote myself to TechTube, I can't demote myself because I'm the same rank. Alright, but theoretically I can go pex user TechTube add, and then I can add a node just for that person. So if I only want one person to have access to broadcast, I can go ahead and do that. And that's really it. So you know how to promote people, you know how to add nodes, you know how to do inheritance. That's pretty much it. If I go ahead, I'm going to go ahead and reload this file. You can also add commands in game. So if you look in here, you can see that it has permissions. I can just delete this and hit save, and it'll get rid of my prefix. You can see Notch is a member and it lists them. So that's how you set up users. That's how I do it. And you can also add permissions to a group directly in game. So if I wanted to go and do pex group member add essentials dot, that's just an example. It's not actually going to do anything. And if, and I forgot to add the slash, because slashes are important. So let me go back here. Slash. Now, if I go over here, hit yes, you will see I added a random permission to members. So that's how you do it from the permissions file, add permissions, give your groups members stuff. So, yeah. Really easy concept. Some plugins will use the asterisk, the universal thing that gives you every single permission. Some plugins will have something like essentials dot whatever, and most plugins will be the plugin name dot and then the node. So that's how you deal with nodes, permissions, groups, things like that. And it's really simple and easy to do, so go get started. I recommend Notepad++, Permission X, as well as chat manager. So go check those links out. The links will be in the description if you found this video helpful. And anyway, make sure to give this video a like, as it really does help me out.